Tattoos can be beautiful works of body art, but it's also nice to know that you don't have to live with tattoos that you don't love forever. So if you want a tattoo permanently removed, the Vein Center at GBMC can help make that happen with state-of-the-art laser tattoo removal. And joining us now to talk much more about it is Kathleen Barinski, nurse practitioner at GBMC. Welcome, Kathleen.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Great to have you here. And look, a very pertinent topic. Many of us here in Maryland have tattoos. Some of these tattoos, maybe we decide later, I want to get this thing removed. So enlighten us here a little bit. How does the process work? Has it changed a lot in recent years? Tell us.
Definitely has changed a lot. The new laser machines are incredible. What happens is you'll come in for a free consultation. The most important thing that I'll do with you is skin typing. We'll talk about if you tan, what happens to your skin when you're in the sun. We'll ask how long have you had the tattoo? Was it placed professionally or a scratch artist or in jail? And it's really important because currently there's no FDA regulations on ink in the United States. So the carrier for the ink could be a number of things, and it makes a big difference. So then we'll take a picture of your tattoo. We have a scale. It's called the Kirby Desai scale, where we'll talk about skin typing, how long it's been there, and it'll determine the number of sessions, approximately, it'll take to remove the tattoo.
Which is a great follow-up question for those getting a tattoo removed or planning to. If they go with you, about how many sessions? About how long could this take?
We would say approximately 8 to 10 sessions, and you have to wait 4 weeks in between for your body to do its work.
I see.
And yeah, our lymphatic system actually carries away the broken up particles of ink.
So you're going to shoot my tattoo with a laser. Is this going to be painful, Kathleen? Is this going to hurt? I mean, tell us. Come on, be honest.
People liken it to being snapped with a hot rubber band.
Okay.
But we have a wonderful little machine called a Zimmer that we will wand 30 degree below cold air on that area, and it really helps with the sting. It takes the edge off.
So a little pain, but you know what? When we had the tattoo put on, there was a little pain involved with that, so maybe equivalent or even less.
Yeah. Definitely.
I like that. Talk about what you brought here today. These are some of the tools of the trade.
We take every precaution for safety. We all have to wear, everyone in the room has to wear these wonderful goggles. And as you can see, they're different colors.
And,
specific to the type of laser we're using.
Okay. And so we'll look cool while we're having this removed.
That's
also protect
right.
our vision because there are lasers involved. And then you have these are like a stress ball that we
stress
can kind of grip and kind of when you're rubber band snapping that tattoo.
Some people need them, some people don't. So everybody's pain tolerance is different.
Very interesting. We want to talk too about, I mean, this is fun, but again, these serve a safe purpose. And it brings up to a good point. Look, we've seen tattoo removal services offered even in strip mall environments. You say there's a big advantage to going to a medical environment such as you offer.
Well, what we've been told is patients feel safer. They're in an environment where it's more controlled. It just overall is a safer place.
And that skin type matching is very critical. You don't want to laser maybe skin pigment in the wrong way or leave a scarring. And that's the last thing. A lot of people have said, I would get my tattoo removed, but I've heard it leaves a lot of scarring. What does your final result look like? Is it almost undetectable?
It should be undetectable, yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that's the key difference.
Yeah, and skin typing is critical because a laser is looking for pigment. So darker skin tone folks are definitely at more risk for hypopigmentation. So it's very critical that we do conservative settings, and we've had great success at GBMC.
Fantastic.
Yeah, over the past year.
Kathleen, thanks so much for coming and talking about this important service out there.
You're
so
welcome.
Much.
It's great to be here.
Reach out to
Come see us.
We will. Reach out to GBMC for further information. And we are back with more Midday Maryland right after this. Stay tuned. Can I keep these glasses?